Now we will learn how to assess finance charges to customers. A finance charge to a customer is interest that we charge customers for money they owe us for open invoices. To be able to charge customers a finance charge, we must first set up finance charges in the Preferences window. We must also add an income account called Interest Earned from Customers. Let's take a look. From the main menu, click Edit Preferences. One of the categories on the left side of the Preferences window is Finance Charge. Click on the Finance Charge category, then click Company Preferences. In our example, we will charge a 24% annual interest rate to all customers. Also in this example, we will only assess Betty's interest as of January 31. So, we click right here in the field next to the words annual interest rate and just type in the number 24. You don't have to type in a decimal point or a percent sign because QuickBooks knows any number in this field is a percent. Now, which account will hold and record all of the income that we earn from customers for charging them interest? When we click the pull-down arrow, we get the full chart of accounts, and you can see there is no income account right now for interest from customers. So we click Add New, and the new account window opens up. Notice account type is already chosen as other income. That's because this is other type of income. This is not the normal way that we earn income from customers. Click in the field for account name, make sure your cap locks is on, and type in interest earned from customers. Now click save and close. And we now told QuickBooks the interest rate that we will charge for all customers. And we told QuickBooks that all the money we earn in interest will be recorded in this account, interest earned from customers. To save these preferences, we simply click OK. And now let's assess Betty for January 31. Click Customers, Assess Finance Charges. Now, notice all three customers are selected, and the date that I'm actually recording this video comes up as the assessment date. Click in the calendar box and go back to the day that you're actually assessing the finance charge. We only sent them a statement as of January 31, so let's assess the finance charge as of January 31, the first month that we recorded transactions in this course. Let's remove the check marks next to Betty, next to Alan and Candy, and take a look at only Betty. We want only the check mark in the row of Betty because we're only assessing Betty's finance charge, what Betty owes us in interest as of January 31. Now you may well ask, why is it that it's $59.84? Well, the money amount of the finance charge has a calculation that will be explained in the next video. So if you're interested how QuickBooks finds the actual number, please watch the video that follows this one. But for now, let's just take a look at what happens after we assess the finance charge. We click Assess Charges and then click Yes, and now let's take a look at what Betty's open invoice looks like. When we click open invoice, we can see that Betty Boop now has an additional invoice. This invoice has a reference number as FC2, meaning finance charge 2. And notice the money amount of the finance charge that we saw in the previous window shows up here as an invoice that Betty needs to pay. The interest we earned from Betty also shows up in the trial balance in the new account that we just created. As soon as we click Assess Finance Charge, this account, Interest Earned from Customers, shows up on the trial balance with the total that we earned from customers for any finance charges that we have assessed.